Investigation is conducted by the police officers, administrative officers, executive officers, not judicial officers. Main purpose of investigation is to collect the evidence of committing a crime. When that point is complete, investigation is complete, a charge sheet will have to be filed by the police to the court. Next stage is not directly trial, there is inquiry. Whether there is a prima facie case, whether the accused should be discharged or charge should be framed, that decision has to be taken by the magistrate. If the accused is discharged, matter ends. If there is prima facie evidence, some evidence that accused committed a crime, then charge will be framed by the court magistrate. Then start the trial. You should not confuse between two words, charge sheet and charge. Charge sheet is what is filed by the police, and charge is what is framed by the magistrate of the court. So charge separates, framing of charge separates inquiry from trial. Inquiry ends, trial starts after the charge. Then all this procedure will be conducted depending upon whether that is a warrant trial or summary trial or trial before the court of session. Main purpose of the trial is to find out whether accused person has committed crime or not. Only one question to be decided on the basis of evidence adduced on both sides. If there is sufficient evidence against the accused, he will be convicted at the end of the trial. End of the trial is conviction. If there is a proof beyond reasonable doubt that accused has committed crime, and this should be on the basis of evidence before the court, convicted. Or there is no proof, or there is no sufficient proof, or there is no proof beyond reasonable doubt, though there is a proof that he committed a crime, then necessarily accused has to be acquitted. That is also end of the trial. Trial ends either with conviction or acquittal. And then may start other stages, appeal and division and review and reference. As a student of criminal procedure code, you should know all this. After conviction or acquittal, there is no end perhaps, depending upon whether either party may prefer an appeal, first or second. This criminal procedure code, which was passed in 1973, and came into force on April Fool Day. It came into force on 1st April 1974, April Fool Day, has made many changes to earlier criminal procedure code. But we will not go into the details of that. But I want to make one point about criminal procedure, civil procedure, a brief reflection on criminal law, civil law. Everybody knows there is a difference between crime and a civil wrong. Civil procedure, criminal procedure different. But gradually this borderline between civil law and criminal law is obliterating, vanishing gradually. The difference between civil law and criminal law. I will prove this by two or three points. There are more also. The first point, there is one maxim. Nullum tempest occurrit regi. This means there cannot be a period of limitation for the king, for the prosecutor. He can file a case after any lapse of time. In civil law, you know there is a period of limitation. Whatever your rights, if they are violated, infringed, within some time prescribed in the Limitation Act, you have to file the case in civil court, otherwise you lose the remedy. There was no such provision in criminal law to file criminal complaints or cases within prescribed time limit till 1973. But this 1973 code first time provides a period of limitation for filing criminal cases. That is a civil law limitation. Against this maxim, nullum tempus occurrit regi. For some crimes, 1 year period of limitation. For some crimes, up to 2 years. For some crimes for which punishment is less than 3 years, period of limitation of 3 years has been prescribed, after which case cannot be filed. The civil law. The principle of civil law incorporated in criminal law first time in 1973. Second point. Civil law is law of compensation, law of damages, payment of money to the aggrieved person by the wrongdoer. Criminal law is a law which punishes the accused, does nothing more. Only object of criminal law is find out whether person has committed crime, punish him, hang him, or send to the prison, or impose fine upon him. Finish. No further. Compensation is not a part of criminal law at all. That is the privilege of civil law. That is the characteristic of civil law. But do you know, in 2009, there is amendment to Criminal Procedure Code. 3 more sections are added, 357A, 357B, 357C, to provide special compensation scheme for the victim.